Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Good evening.
Amen.
That is not simply a greeting. It is a statement of fact. It is a good evening. A good evening to gather together, a good evening in part by the blessings that have been shared with us tonight. I want to extend my personal thank you to each one of the gifted musicians and dancers. But a special thank you to Reverend Claire Lewis for her attention to detail in pulling together a night like this. On my way up here this evening, I was reminded of a conversation I had about this same time last year. I asked a young lady in the life of our congregation, "So, what do you want this Christmas?" And with just a little tune in her attitude, she said to me, "Pastor Bruce, this is not the time to be talking about what we want. This is the season about giving." I was a little taken back, in a good way, by what she said. But before I could celebrate her words, she said, "But since you asked," and then proceeded to offer a list that was lengthy, was extensive, and expensive. Well, in that conversation, I was reminded that this is a season to give and receive, to share and accept, to bless and to be blessed. And tonight, I think we can all say that we have received, we have accepted, we have been blessed. And so I am going to invite you, if you would consider, to give a gift, to share, to bless, so that in part, events like this can continue to happen. In just a moment, ushers will be coming forward with offering baskets. And so again, I would like you to consider giving a gift as you have, well, been on the receiving end tonight of a gift. Thank you.
Thank you. a word of thanks and appreciation for Dr. Ann Frobeek. Ann brings such tremendous talent to us in her playing, as does Sharon Goldsberry. Ann has been leading the way in our pipe organ project. If you'll notice near the back of your program, we've had some wonderful news in the last couple of months that we've had a major foundation from Pennsylvania who's so excited about what we offer here and the opportunities for people to hear a splendid instrument that they've given us a significant grant. We still have some matching to do, but wouldn't it be wonderful to hear her play a real instrument in this area up here filled with glistening pipes? If you would like to be a part of that wonderful finishing of this beautiful space, please contact us and we'll tell you how you can become a part of our pipe dream becoming a reality.
Thank you. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed, and all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of Nazareth, into Judea, and unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, who was great with child. And so it was that the days were accomplished that she would be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them at the inn. And there were shepherds in the same country, shepherds abiding in their field, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for I bring you good tidings of